Hello, in this video, I will review the button update for CLO3D in version 7.0. I look really hard in my closet to find something with lots of buttons. This is the best I could do. It just has lots of rivets, some buttons, but I did find a tie-dye top that you will see how it fits in the theme in about a second. Hello everyone, in this video we will test the new button function updates in CLO3D version 7.0. So here I have a tote bag with a kind of cool tie-dye print on it. And I already have a couple of buttons here, but I don't really need them, so I'm going to remove them. Let's go to the 3D window. I will simply right-click and delete each button individually. And you can do that either with the select tool, or you could also go to the select move button and use that tool to right click and then delete each individual button. The button function now utilizes an internal line on which you can distribute the buttons. So let's go back to our two windows and we will work in the 2D window. Let's close also the property editor and the object browser so we have more space. And let's take a look at where we might want to place some buttons. So for example, on this tote bag, I'd like to place some buttons along the strap all the way from one side to the other. So let's go just to the 2D window so I can see the strap better. I would like to have an internal line that's right in the middle. So I will measure what is the distance or the width of my strap. I'm gonna left click on this and it shows me that this strap is 1.5 inches. So I know that 0.75 would be exactly the middle of it. So I'm gonna utilize my edit pattern tool. I'm gonna right click on my outline and I'm gonna select offset as internal line. For the distance, I would like this to be exactly 0.75 and I will type exactly 0.75 and I'm gonna click OK. You can see that I have this line right in the middle. That's my internal line. And because my straps are linked with symmetric editing, you can see that the internal line appeared on both of them. I am now ready to place buttons along this internal line, but I do want to know what kind of buttons are available to me. So if you go under the object browser in the button section, you will see that you may have just a default button. I have already placed one additional button here. And if you want to change that, you can come in the property editor, select the button that you want or add a new button. And under this button, you can left click, change the name of it. So that could be some kind of a trim that you would like to utilize. It could be a special shape, so give it that name. And here in the property editor, come to shape, left click once on the arrow pointing down and you will see all of the options that you have here. So I have selected here this octagon. I will create one more button here just for the purpose of our demo. So I'm going to select one of these grommets just to have one additional one. You can also come here and change the color, for example, and utilize a different color and make sure that that is also something that works well with your designs. So we're ready to distribute buttons on our strap. Let's go to a split view screen where we see both the 3D and the 2D window, and we will start placing buttons on our strap. Let's clean our area by closing the object browser and the property editor so we have a better view of both the 2D and the 3D window. The first step of the process is to select the internal line with the edit pattern tool. That would be the internal line along which we will place the buttons. So we select the internal line in the 2D window and then we come to the 3D window and now we can left click once on the button tool. Now we have the button tool in our hands and we will come back to the 2D window. Let's get a closer look at this. And all we have to do here is right click once on the internal line. That gives us a pop-up window and now we can start giving our best selections here. First, under type, left click once and select distribute. That will give us the option to distribute multiple buttons along the internal line. Then I would work with the start interval and end interval. That depends on the beginning and end. And I would start with something that's pretty close. I will start with half an inch for the beginning and for the end. Obviously, you can select something different. Maybe 1 inch is better for you. Let's give it 1 inch. So you can see where the first button gets placed here in the 2D window. Next, I would select the number of buttons. That's down here. It says number of buttons and buttonholes. Currently, I have only two. As you start clicking on more buttons in the 2D window, you see them becoming prominent and you can see them also starting to arise. These happen to be starting from the back and you can see the first one start to appear here. You'll see them kind of crawling up and appearing from the top as I'm adding more buttons. So this is actually on the back strap, so it is hard to see. It would be better to give you a back view of this. Let me click OK. And you can see how the buttons appeared on the full strap in the back. Now let's do the same thing for the other strap so you can see this better. I will shift my view for the 2D screen. So now we'll place buttons on this particular strap. Now let's work with the strap on the front and let's place buttons along this internal line. In the 2D window, either with the transform tool or the edit pattern tool, you select the internal line, click once on it, then come to the 3D window and select the button tool. And now you can come back to the 2D window and right click once on the internal line. Right click and you will get this pop-up window. And here you have all of the choices that you need to make. First, select distribute. That will give you the option to place as many buttons as you want. Then let's place the start and the end interval. I'm going to start with 1 inch to be consistent on both sides. That gives me this distance here. How far do you want to place this button from the edge in the beginning and the end? Now let's select how many buttons do we want. So I'm going to keep adding buttons now. I'm going to move this window a little bit so we can see better what happens in the 3D window. So as I click down here on the number of buttons, you will see them appear on the other sides. Currently we have 5, 6, and you can see them kind of appearing on the strap, both in the 2D and the 3D window. And they look a bit more crowded here in the 2D window as this appears a lot smaller, but we have a better perspective here in the 3D window. So I'm going to go with 16 buttons. That seems like a good number, and I like the spacing here. I am happy with 16 buttons, so I'm going to click OK. And now I have the distribution here with the button that I have currently selected. If you want to change the type of button that you're using, then come back to Object Browser, Property Editor, and assign a different button or play around with the settings of the button that you want. So I selected this button here. I can obviously change the name of it. I can also select it. Make sure you have the Property Editor open, and I can change the texture of it, the color of it, and anything else that you want to play with. I am currently happy with my distribution, and let's take a look at my bag. I have a couple of leftover buttons here, so I'm going to click on the select move button and then I'm going to right click and delete the ones that I don't want. That will remove just one button at a time. Let's also do one more freeform variation. So I'm going to open both 2D and 3D windows so I can play around with the shapes. I'm going to close for now the property editor and object browser. I don't really need them. And I'm going to come down here to my internal shapes, or I can work with an internal polygon line, create my own shape. I'm going to start working with something that is pre-done. So I'll do an internal ellipse maybe. And in 2D window, I'm going to place a circle. I'm going to hold the shift line to make sure that this is perfectly symmetrical. And that will be one of my new internal lines. I will also come here to the internal polygon line, shortcut G, and I will also create some kind of a freeform line. I'm going to create a freeform curved line starting from the bottom. So that will be my freeform line. And I will create buttons on both of these. So we'll go through the same process. Make sure that your internal line is selected. Then come to the 3D window, select the button. Then come and right click on the internal line where you want to place the buttons. Again, I will choose here under type distribute. Then I will place a start interval. I'm going to go a bit closer here. I'll do 0.5, so the start and the end. And then I will increase the number of buttons. I actually can't see these right here because this happens to be the other side of the bag. Let me click OK and rotate this bag so I can see where this decorative element is. And if you're happy with that, you move on to the next one. So I'm going to come back to the 2D window, select my internal line, grab the button, right click on the line. And here is why you should have the internal line pre-selected. You could still come to the button tool and start right clicking. But if you have a complex shape that has multiple segments with multiple points, then if you just hover over the line, it will initially select only that segment between the two points, only that segment that you have selected. If you want to select the full shape of the internal line, then you would have to hold the shift and select multiple lines. So I'm holding shift and left clicking in order to select the lines. Now I have three segments selected, and now I can right click on that and start working on how many and what kind of buttons I want to place along this internal line. Now I can start working on what kind of buttons, how many, and how do I want to position them on this internal line. So the process is exactly the same. I will right click anywhere on the selected internal line. I have the pop-up window. I choose distribute. I choose the distance where I want to have my buttons for start and for an end. I will do it different here, and you can see that this button is much closer than this one from the beginning and the end. And I will also choose how many buttons do I want. The more buttons I put, you can see how they are adding. And I will add a lot of buttons so they're almost touching. So I am happy with that distribution. I am happy with my number of buttons. I can see them in the 2D and the 3D window. And once I am happy with all my choices, click OK. And you can see how they appear in your window. And again, if you want to choose any of the properties, you can still control what kind of buttons these are. If you want to change to which kind this is, you can designate a new one in the object browser, and you can also change the colors, the textures, and anything else. So here is my bag with all of the various buttons that I added as trim. I didn't add any buttonholes because these are trims. And maybe one more thing here is, if you don't want to see the internal line, you can also come here and uncheck show internal lines. That will remove the internal lines and you will not be able to see them. I can also make this internal shape match my design better, and I can change the internal shape altogether. So for example, I can select this shape. I want it to match my tie-dye design better. So I'm going to make this a bit smaller. I can move it closer to the shape of the tie-dye design here. So I want it to be more in the center. The only issue here is because I made the shape smaller, now I have less buttons around it. But this, I am happier now. I could also extend the line, make it more of a circle, or change the shape altogether by adding points to it. I could add additional points that I can then grab and manipulate, or I can completely change the shape of it into something brand new. And you can see that affect the design in the 3D window and completely change. So the buttons are still there. Again, if you make it smaller or bigger, that's the only thing that will affect the count of the buttons. Please feel free to leave any comments, ask me any questions, and I appreciate your suggestions for any new videos. Anything you would like to know and learn, please let me know. Thank you for watching.